So hello everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new FIFA 21 video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you the best way to play with Real Sociedad, in my opinion of course. I got a few requests in comments to make a video about Real Sociedad, so I tried a few things out, few formations, few tactics and stuff like that, and for me, for my feeling, this is the best way to play with them. I'm going to show you the formation, lineup, tactics and instructions, so if you want to try it out yourself, make sure you will watch the whole video, set everything the same up like I did, and yeah, go on in a match in online seasons, and yeah, let's see how far you can go with this. Would I recommend to play with this team? Not really, and that's because they have lots and lots of slow players. I'm going to show you all the players here, and as you can see, they are not really fast, and yeah, speed is just a really important thing in my eyes. In FIFA, only this guy Porto is really fast, and all the other players are around 60 or 70 pace, so that's really, really slow. So I would not recommend to play with this team in online seasons, because when you're facing other 4.5-star teams like Dortmund, like Chelsea, maybe just even 5-star teams, and yeah, if you are looking to all the players that you have and that they will have, they have all better players. So I will not recommend to play with this, but if this is your favorite team or you just want to try it out, go ahead, try it out this way, and yeah, this is the biggest chance you will win, in my opinion. Yeah, first of all, I want to thank you very much for watching, of course. Please drop a like under the video if you think this video is really useful for you. You can also subscribe to my channel, it's free to do, of course. I'm doing lots of tactic videos for other teams. If you have a request about some kind of team, you can put it in the comments below and I will see what I can do for you. I'm doing also tutorial videos and also videos with gameplay in it. I'm also streaming on Twitch, so if you're interested in see me playing online seasons with teams like this, or just random teams, sometimes I'm picking a team with my eyes closed, sometimes I'm doing a request from someone in the chat. So if you are interested in that, go to my Twitch. The link is in the description and follow me over there and join the live stream when I'm streaming. All right, we're going to start now. 4-2-2-2 formation, as you already saw, maybe. Ramiro is the goalkeeper. Goro Sabel is the right defender. Zubeldia, sorry that. He is center back. Elustondo is the other center back. And then we have Monreal on the left side. Ilyara Mendy and Marino are the central midfielders. Ilyara Mendy will be the most defensive one and Marino the most attacking one. David Silva, central attacking midfielder on the right side. Oyarzabal on the left side. Two strikers, William, Jose and Porto. Then we're going to the tactics. The defensive style is balanced with a width of 4 bars and a depth of 4 bars. I would not recommend to play possession, pressure with this team, because you have really slow players, and when you lose the ball and you want to play pressure, it would be very nice if you have fast players, because they are running fast to the ball, to your opponent that has the ball, and then your opponent doesn't have really much time to decide what to do. If you have slow players, they will run slow to your opponent and he has more time to see what he is going to do, and yeah, there will be a bigger chance that he will football his way around your pressure and go on an attack. So I will not recommend to play pressure with this team, so balanced is good enough. Offensive style is offensive style is possession, and also because you don't have fast players. Only Porto is the fastest guy in this team. I'm going to show you the instructions later. But when there is not an opportunity to give him a through ball when he is making a run, you will need to be patient, pass the ball around where you can, and yeah, build up your attack really patiently and yeah, secure. The width is 5 bars, and that's because the two central attacking midfielders, especially for David Silva, if you are putting this wider, he will play more like a winger than an attacking midfielder. And he is really slow, and his only good stats are passing and dribbling and shooting a bit. But yeah, he is really good at passing and dribbling, so you want him in the center of the field. So don't put this too wide. 5 bars is enough, in my opinion. Players in the box, 7 bars. Corners, free kicks, both 3 bars. Then we're going to the instructions. Goalkeeper is default. Right defender, stay back while attacking, because everybody is really slow and you don't want to be an easy target on a counter attack. So you want these guys at the back. All the center backs, all both are just default. Monreal the same as the other one. Stay back while attacking, and I'm pushing the wrong button here. Sorry. Instructions. Monreal, stay back while attacking. Then we are going to Ilar and Mendy. Cut passing lanes, stay back while attacking, and cover center. As we already said, he is the most defensive midfielder. Marino, cut passing lanes, get forward, and cover center. Get forward because I like one of those two to go attacking, because else you only have four players that are going to attack, and that's not really much. And in the central of the midfield, you already you will have a player that is available for a pass, and that will this guy be. And I'm putting him on get forward because he has medium work rate, so he don't go forward by himself that much, so we instruct him to do that. Then we have Silva, free roam. The same for the guy on the left side, Oyarzabal, free roam. Porto, I already said, stay central, get him behind, so he is going to make the runs behind your defender, behind the defenders of your opponent. And when he is making a good run, give him a through ball, especially with Silva. He's really, really good at passing, of course. And you will go one-on-one on the goalkeeper and create your chance. If there's not an opportunity to give him a through ball, pass the ball around on your midfield and build up your attack really, really patiently and easily. And try to reach William Jose or whatever. He is really good at shooting. He is a really strong striker. So for him, only stay central is good enough, and he will do his thing, and almost every game can score a goal because he's a really good shooter. So that's it for Real Sociedad. I hope you like it. Please try it out yourself and let me know in the comments what you think of it and what your results are. I'm really curious about that. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.